Welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use MetaMask with your hardware wallet for the Songbird network. So right now, for clean installation of MetaMask, so here's nothing else. I just create a new wallet here, and I've got my Ledger Nano S right now connected. So I'm going to open that one here, and you can see here that I've got some apps already installed. And the first thing we have to do is to install the Songbird app. So we're going to go to the app catalog. Just enter Songbird here and we can install it. One important thing here is if you need to also have the Ethereum app. So you need to install the Ethereum app and then Songbird. Or also if you don't have it installed, it's going to force you to install Ethereum first. And then just click on install. And right, so after having done this, you cannot open the Songbird app on the Ledger Nano S. So you can open it, but it doesn't really offer much functionality there. So I'm going to really minimize that. And we're back here. And I'm also going to close the Ledger Live app. So after you've installed it, you're good to go. And now the only thing you have to do is you have to click onto the profile. So I'm going to even go to the school. And you just have to click on the MetaMask icon here. And then click on the icon here, and then there is something called Connect Hardware Wallet. So you just click onto that and click on Ledger, then click on continue. And then you also have to open on the Ledger Nano S, you open the Songbird app. So open that one by just navigating to the Songbird app and pressing both buttons. So right now it's gonna read out my account. So it's just gonna take a short while. So, right. This is trying. I might have to restart though. It seems to be laggy. So I'm gonna just restart here again. All right. So I also had to issue it first. I'm just gonna disconnect the Ledger again. And I'm gonna connect it again. So sometimes it happens. So if this happens to you, yeah, also just disconnect the Ledger and Nano S again. Enter the password and directly open the Songbird app. And I'm gonna try that again. I also have to think that I don't think I'm using it anywhere else. I'm clicking on Songbird again. And I will be clicking on continue. And then hopefully it works. So it keeps going. So just wait for that. And complete it again. That is definitely not good. So I'm gonna quickly pause the video. All right, so I would recommend first opening the Ethereum app, I guess, because we don't have the RPC in there yet, that it doesn't work yet. So you can see I want the clean installation and does not have a custom RPC yet. So I would recommend that you just click on Connect Hardware Wallet and open the Ethereum app first. So it doesn't matter if you open Songbird or the Ethereum app, because it's gonna have the same address anyway. So just open the Ethereum app and then wait a few seconds until it's completing that, and come on, it used to work just a few seconds ago. Okay, it's a little annoying here. Just gonna try it again. So I'm gonna go to the Ethereum app, like I said, on my Ledger Nano, and I'm gonna click and continue. And yep, I think I just opened the wrong app again. And now I've got my addresses here. So as you know, you can calculate as many addresses as you want to. Oh no, ah, damn it. I just wanted to show you that you can derive from one mnemonic as many other addresses as you want to. So I have to click on previous again, because I have already some Songbird in my account though. So again, so I have to click on back and it just will do the same thing here. And it seems to be all again to be bugging, so it's not very cool. So you can see it's a little buggy and whatever, but I'm gonna click on Connect Hardware Wallet again, and hopefully this time I did it right. Okay, seems to look good here, and then just select the first one and click on Unlock. So then it's just gonna take a few seconds again, and I've got my account here. And right now I'm connected to the Ethereum mainnet. So like I said, the address is the same no matter to what network you connect. So that's fine. And what we need to do now is, like I said, add the custom RPC. So you click on custom RPC. And now we will just have to copy all the info. So Songbird is simple, you just enter that. Now we need the RPC URL. So we just copy that one here. Then we need the chain ID, which is 19. So also it's just there. then it's SGB and then copy the Explorer thing here as well. And then save that. And then we can connect, just click on Songbird and you can see I've got already a balance there. So that's also interesting to know. And like I said, if you now would use any other tool via MetaMask, you can see that it's gonna ask us now. So whatever, let's use, well, let's go to Flare Metrics and just go to the dApp website of any other Oracle. So let's just go whatever to maybe the Scanning Notes, I think has a dApp. So let's just go to Scanning Notes here. And let's see. We could have also gone to Flare Finance, but right now I'm gonna go to Scanning Notes. And they have the, I guess the FTSO service, yeah, that one, and then on the web app here, and then we can click on connect MetaMask. And in this case, I want to connect this one here. That's my hard wallet. So next, I'm going to click on connect here. And now, for example, I want to wrap some of Songbird, and I can say I want to wrap 5. And now I have to open not the Ethereum wallet app. I have to go to my Ledger Nano, and from now on, only open the Songbird app. And now the Songbird app is gonna be, okay, I'm just gonna click on confirm for now, all right. And now it's checking here. And now the now it's failing because the Songbird app wants blind signing. So it's also next part you have to do. You have now to go to the Songbird app on Ledger Nano, go navigate to settings, so you navigate twice to the right. So from the point we start, navigate twice to right, and then there's settings, and then press both buttons to go into settings, and then enable blind signing, then enable that. And after you've done that, you can click on try again. I'm gonna click on 5, click on wrap here, and now again confirm. Now the transaction is being sent to my Ledger device. Now I can review the transaction, and if everything is fine there, then I can click on accept and send as always, and then you're done. But these are the steps and hiccups I've gone over when trying to set up a hardware wallet with MetaMask in order to use Songbird. But I just wanted to give you my findings or tell you how it works. And after doing all of that, then we're good to go. Right, so that's it. So also there's a part, add wrap Songbird to MetaMask. That's also a cool thing, so just click on that. Because right now MetaMask, wrap Songbird is a token. And therefore it's handy if you just add that, because then you can see it in MetaMask. So if you just look here, you can see now under assets that I've got now 10 wrap Songbird. All right, so that's it for this video. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.